Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is another video all about traveling with little ones, specifically flying. I know flying can be stressful on a good day, but throw in little ones and it can be a super big headache. I have flown a bunch with my daughter. She's 2.5. All of our family is out of state and I've been taking her on planes since she was very, very little, a little baby. She's been dozens of times now and we definitely have some tips and tricks up our sleeves. Today I'm specifically gonna talk about getting through TSA with a toddler. I think a lot of people would say the TSA line, security line, is the most stressful part about flying. You know, you're in a long line, you've gotta have all your stuff out and organized. It can be stressful. And if you have sort of like a plan, if you are methodical about it, I think getting through TSA with a little one, it can be a lot less of a hassle than it has to be. I have some notes here that I want to talk to you guys about. Number one, if you aren't aware, I want to make sure you know that you can take your stroller through TSA. You don't have to give it up. You don't have to check it when you're checking into your flight. When you check your baggage, you can bring your stroller through TSA, you can bring your car seat through TSA. And then when you get to the gate for your flight, the stewardesses will take it for you. They'll put it in stowaway. Stowaway, that's not the right, you know what I mean. They'll stow it for you and they won't charge you anything. And I like making sure that I have my stroller with me because as you're going through the airport, it's nice to have a spot where you can put your little one in the stroller, push them, they're not having to walk, you're not having to carry them. On that topic though, they are going to ask you to put your stroller through that belt, the moving belt where they x-ray everything. They're gonna ask you to put that up there. I've seen some mamas going through TSA and they didn't know this and they've loaded down their stroller with stuff, right? They've hooked bags on the handles, that little area underneath the seat, they've stuffed it full of stuff, the baby's still all locked up, and now the TSA agent says, I need you to break that down and put it up on the belt, and it's like crisis mode. How do you organize all this stuff? So I wanna make sure you know that they are gonna ask you to break that down and put it through the belt. So heading into the security process, just make sure your stroller is clear of stuff, take everything out, put it in your carry-on. If you're traveling with somebody, ask them to hold some of your stuff, have that cleared out. If you have a stroller that you don't think is going to fit on that belt, that's okay. I've been in that situation before. I have told the TSA people plenty of times, you know, it's not gonna fit. They usually make me prove it. They'll say, no, I think it will. They are in the habit of believing that they can get it to fit because most will fit. And I've seen other mothers going through the line who said, mine won't fit. And they'll tell her, yes, it will. And they'll fold it up and it does fit. But if yours does not fit, they'll just pull it through, they'll open up a little belt, and somebody will manually check it. So don't worry about that so much, but do make sure you've got it clear of stuff. That's gonna make that process so much easier for you. The next thing I want to talk about is food and drinks, specifically formula, milk. If your baby is still using a bottle, you should know that you can bring those items through the security line, and that's great. However, it can add a little bit extra hassle because when they see those bottles, those cups of milk, they're going to remove them and they're going to make you get out of line, stand to the side, and they're going to manually check them just to make sure there's nothing hazardous. To kind of circumvent that, I just don't bring milk through the line. My baby does use milk, but what I do is I just bring her an empty bottle. She likes the bottle for takeoff. It's a nice security thing. But then I just buy the milk at one of those like little newsstands or something once I've already gone through the line. It's a little bit extra cost. Of course, the milk is more expensive at the airport than if I was buying it at home, but I find it just saves me time getting through that line, and I'll do anything to get through that line a little bit faster. On that note, however, if you have like a carry-on bag and you send it through the x-ray with an empty bottle, they're gonna see that bottle and they're gonna wanna pull it out and look at it. So again, to save myself some time, even though the bottle's empty and I'm gonna wait to buy my liquids, I will take the bottle out and I'll put it in one of those baskets and put it through so that they can visually see it's a bottle, but it is empty. I do this with water as well, like my daughter's sippy cup. I make sure it's empty, but I set it out just so they know this is empty, there's nothing hazardous. Also on this same topic, snacks, if you're bringing like goldfish and gummy snacks, they do wanna see those things. If you have them all just packed up in your bag, there's a fairly good chance that the bag is gonna go through and they're gonna pull the bag aside to manually go through it. So just take out all your snacks. I put them in like a gallon freezer bag so it's see-through and I can just pull all the snacks out and put it in a basket. And that way the agents can look at it, they can see what it is, and they know that there's nothing hazardous here. Another thing to keep in mind is identification. Sometimes your baby will need identification. If you're traveling with your child and he or she is under 2, you don't have to buy them a ticket. They fly for free, which is great. And so, of course, they don't need an ID. They're not going to have a ticket that they're checking ID to. However, they will sometimes ask to see a birth certificate for a few reasons. They like to make sure you're traveling with a child that is your child. And also sometimes they want to check it just to make sure that child really is under 2, that you're not taking advantage of the system. But I want to make sure you know you do not actually have to bring the birth certificate. This used to send me into a panic because it's such a precious piece of information, and I was worried traveling with my daughter's birth certificate, what if I lose it? They will accept a photocopy. So what I do is I take a photo of my daughter's birth certificate on my phone, and then when you're going through the line, if TSA asks to see the child's birth certificate, you can just show them that photo actually on your phone, and that works just fine. I do want to point out that I've flown with my daughter maybe 20 times, and maybe only 25% of those times they've asked to see the birth certificate. So you are probably not going to need it, but just in case, use that photocopy. And finally, I want to talk about things like lovies and pacifiers. My daughter has a beloved stuffed lamb. It goes everywhere she goes. She doesn't use a pacifier anymore, but when she did use it, she used one of those Wubbanubs. You know, the little pacifier with the toy hanging off of it. She loved the Wubbanub. These are things that are very much security items for her. And you should know, if you haven't done this before, that going through the security line, the security people are going to ask those items go through the x-ray, go on the bell. And the first few times that we went through this, it was a little bit traumatizing for my daughter. She's in this new environment, right? There's all these strangers and noises, and now we're taking away her security items. So I just prepare her before we're doing it. I let her know, okay, we're gonna take Lammy, we're gonna put him in the basket, and Lammy's going for a ride. And I make it a little bit of a game. Where's Lammy? Oh, let's watch him. And then we watch for him coming out the other end. I just find preparing her so that she knows it's coming, it's a lot less traumatic than if we were right up there and then I yanked it out. So if you have a child that has those security items, a blanket, a stuffed animal, a pacifier, just know mentally going into it, you are going to have to take those items away from them. They have to get checked. I think this will help you from being traumatized as well. I don't want mama to be stressed out. Just know you do have to put those items aside. And those are my best tips. I find that keeping these things in mind has really streamlined our travel process. Like I said, the TSA, the security line, it's such a headache, isn't it? There's masses of people. Everybody's trying to get somewhere. Bring extra patience. That's really my best tip. Pack extra patience and you'll be just fine. Let me know in the comments below if you have any tips to add to this, because I love getting travel tips from you mamas. I always need them. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it so I know to do more travel videos. I love sharing what I've experienced. I love hearing what you guys have to say. And hit that red subscribe button so you don't miss out on future videos. I do really easy projects, mama life. Lifestyle. I will see you guys next time.